he didn't see the point in tissue. He ate like the wrong person. He loved toast and lamb that fell from the bone, but it was a secret, quite indecent, that he had no bum hole, just a small, smooth, rounded dog. Doctors tossed in their beds that night. How could they make Eric's possible right? What would they need to do to give Eric not one bum cheek but two? On television, they reported, "Hello, that is Eric Bumless. We're here from the US. We'd love to talk to you about the fact that you're bumless. Is that true? See, Mary R. from Wichita, she's got a Wikiana lunar. Would you fancy meeting her? What do you say? Maybe the two of you could shack up. Wouldn't that be two? Have British babies in Waterloo? And by the way, how do you do?" That's when became the top down of the papers all over the equator. The catchphrase for the new kitchen chic car scraper, "How do you do?" Yeah, we just love him. We got posters all of them. I'm dead proud of him. There's something about him. I think he's nasty. Not being funny, but has he gone crazy? And the gossip it travels, the news it spreads, knocks about for an age like Pizza Hut, garlic bread, and mothers put their legs together, doctors put their heads together, and scientists probably did something that looked impressive with some bumps and burners. The report card scribbled over, unfound cause. Unknown cure. It is almost as though the whole was arranged by some sort of Hitler hole hater. It is literally non-existent. Persistent journalist knocked on the front door. "We don't want to speak with you anymore. Besides, we never had to buy a single crappy napkin. You know what they say? If it ain't broke, don't fix it." So here it was. The newspapers wiggled away. Besides, a baby psychops girl was born that day. And how the rest of the world never heard about the bumless boy is quite beyond me, but at least now I've told you, and it's not a lie, honestly.